Hey guys.
Oh.
Jeez, really? Are you done? Hey guys, Mike here, one go short play. Playing Cygnus 8 for the Commodore Amiga. This is a 1996 game for the Amiga 1200. Emulating as usual. I like that little effect it's got on the screen, that's kind of cool. Let's see what this game's all about. That's good. We'll go with 3, eh? Average. We're not a complete wuss. Other disc being disc 2. The only downside with the emulator is I have to pause it to change the disc. So it doesn't quite give you a true impression of the Amiga experience there. Obviously that music would all still be playing and it would all still be like this. But yeah, you know. We're not losing too much by emulating this. So that's kind of cool. Anyway, how are these going, do you think, then? Me talking over these videos. I don't have a password. I don't want a password. As I say, I'm doing it just for a bit of fun and to mix things up a bit. I hope you're enjoying it. If you're not, I can always go back to just quiet gameplay videos. I'm happy to do that. Do let me know in the comments. I say in the comments, what often happens is YouTube doesn't tell me people have commented. So if I'm not answering you for ages and you do comment, that's why. I guess I'll do a batch of these and then the proof will be in the proof of the pudding will be in the eating, I suppose. And people will tell me if they prefer the sound of my voice or can't stand it. Right, what's this game about anyway? Let's have a look. Okay. We can go to Mill, Steelworks, Botanic. I don't even know what this is. You are on the planet. Alright, that. Is that an iron elf? Aldebaran. Let's call it Aldebaran. It is now morning. Make your choice by using the joystick. And all we can do is go left and right. Let's go to the mill. That's the first thing it tells you to do anyway. Ah, we actually go to the mill. We're going to buy some goods. Go into the mill and greet the owner. She asks if you require assistance. Make your choice by using the joystick. Do I buy goods? Do I sell goods? Price list or exit? You know what? Let's just go for it and buy some goods. How many boxes of grain will you buy? Each one will cost you 10 credits. Yeah. How many credits have I got? There. 1,500 credits. Let's buy 10. Let's go crazy and buy 10. Your goods have been transferred to your cargo bay. Thank the miller and leave. Okay. Or just press fire and get out of here. Steelworks. It's got to be some kind of weapon-y thing, hasn't it? There's got to be weapons to be had here. That music is quite intense. Okay, and it's coming out of my speakers quite loud. So I'm going to turn it down. That might be a good idea for general videos, actually. Turn the speakers down. Yeah. The worker bids you welcome to the shop. He inquires as to your line of business. My line of business is making the choice via a joystick. Steel girders. I'm going to buy, let's see. 10 steel girders. Thank you. Okay, let's go to the botanicals. I'm going to buy some flowers. Bagels, botanicals, greet the owner, serve you, choice joystick, right, got ya. I'm seeing a pattern here. How many rare plants will you buy? Wow, that's quite cheap for rare plants. Let's buy... No, I haven't bought any. I press fire. Let's buy... Ooh. 10. Bye. Okay, where next? Let's go to the oil refinery. What? This is a weird shopping trip. I'm not quite sure what my motivation is to buy oil and flowers and whatever else. Or girders. Girders. The refinery owner welcomes you, asking for a resistance joystick. Right. What is he selling me? Drums of oil, 12! Ah, oh, it's cheap. It would be rude to buy any less than, 10. Thank you, leave, right. Goldsmith, I'm going to run out of money before I get through all these, aren't I? What a weird shopping trip this is. Oh! It's trading! Traders, spaceport, Well, why didn't you say so? I might have wasted a lot of money here. Shall we just explore a few more places? Okay, this is where being able to talk to you on a microphone makes a lot of sense. Because normally, I'm saying a list to myself. And my decisions in-game might not make any sense to someone just watching the gameplay. So it's kind of working out that I'm doing this microphone-y talky thing. Goldsmith. Do we want to buy more stuff? Outside of Goldsmith, which is closed. Do you want to steal? No, we don't want to steal. Let's not steal stuff. I want to see stuff. And if I steal stuff, then I'll probably get arrested and won't be able to see stuff. And the same applies to the toolworks. Has it just gone night time? Oh, it's now evening and you are peckish. I'm peckish. I like the prompt. Computer Factory Church. Where would you get food? Yeah, let's go to the pub. Let's get wrecked and start a brawl. Oh, look, it's got a little coin up. I hope that is a proper coin up machine. I'm not just a one-armed bandit. So, you enter the pub, serving drinks, evening meal, lodgings, night. Press 5 for prices. Yeah, come on, let's get some grub. Food, drink 56, snack 103, meal 14. I think I should probably have a meal. Have a proper dinner before I go to bed. Pay the barmaid, eat meal, completely full and satisfied. That's cool. Let's press that fire button, continue. Okay. Room, it is evening after all. It's a bit of a weird combination. It gives you the impression, right, that you're kind of in the future and you've got spaceports and stuff. And then you've suddenly got an icon with a candle next to a bed, like we're in some kind of medieval times. And then the artwork for the backgrounds and stuff look like circa 1984. So, I mean, that's like some teenager's bedroom. It probably is some teenager's bedroom who programmed this. Took a picture of their room and they're putting it in the game. That explains it. It's not very futuristic though, is it? You know, where's the consistency? You pay the barmaid, she hands you the key to a little room above the pub, you fall asleep. Alright. I'm not saying it's a bad game, it's just some weird inconsistencies. Breakfast? Did it just ask me to get breakfast? Ah, forget breakfast. I want to go and fly a spaceship. Who wouldn't? Okay, spaceport. Come on, give me a spaceship. As if you're going to give me a spaceship. What's that? Your craft waits in the spaceport. Launching pad service. Reshield or refuel? Let's fly. Alright, well, yeah, reshield me. And refuel me. I think I've done that. They didn't really give me any feedback to tell me. Oh, yes, let's go. Come on. A security officer. Oh, really? Prevent you from entering a ship to your passport. Oh, no. There goes my instant fun. Exit. Passport. Passport. Spaceport. Ministry. Where would you buy a passport from in this place? Ministry of Cygax. Okay, start mission, abort mission, report back. Oh, you're the ministry. Right, okay, got you. I'm like Bond now. Right, I love that in the future they've got CRT monitors. That's so cool. Very retro. Greet by Colonel Baker, sent to Ministry of Cygax. Make your selection. Shall we start a mission? Abort a mission. I didn't know we were on a mission. Let's start one. Mission red one. What? You're not going to tell me the mission? A selection of missions. Pick a colour. Any colour. This is your life-threatening mission. Okay. Let's go for red one. Free maybe use ministry. Acquire 1500. Are you joking? I've just spent that much. Oh, if I'd accepted that mission right at the beginning. I could have completed it now. Oh well, can't be helped. Let's accept it anyway and just see what happens. Exit the ministry. You will not give me a passport, clearly. Text off. Oh no, I like the text. The text's cool. Why would you turn the text off? There's no voice. Traders Hill. Can you sell me a dodgy passport? Either way, we're kind of at the 10 minutes. This was Cygnus 8 on the Amiga. And it's not bad. I might get into it a little bit more. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.